Okay, so what is up guys? Now Frustraeders back at it again with another Bitcoin update as always every day, no? So today is March 7, 2023 na malapit na mag 9 PM. Bakit ako na late? As usual, may mga ginawa ako kanina. Okay? So again, nabanggit ko kanina na today is March 7, 2023 and if we are going to the to look at the trading economics calendar, eh meron tayo ditong event. I think this is going to be significant since the Fed Chair Powell is going to speak later or meron siyang share na testimony. Kung anong lalabas, hindi ko alam. Kung anong oras, that is going to be 11 p.m. PH time. Ibig sabihin, 11 p.m. we can, or habang papalapit ang 11 p.m., we can expect some volatility. And in case, no, that is going to be a negative testimony or it may be a negative news for the markets, eh, most probably, the traditional market is going to fall down. If that is going to be the case, I don't think that the crypto or market is going to hold against the traditional markets. If the traditional markets is going to go down, most probably, the crypto market will also go down. Kasi nga, you know, kung hindi nyo pa napapanood to, shinare ko yun dito sa video na to last Sunday. So, I suggest you watch it. So, dito tayo ngayon sa ating daily chart kay Bitcoin. So, dito sa Bitcoin daily chart, kung mapapansin nyo, the recent daily candle closed as a bearish doji pa din. Sir H, bakit bearish doji? Eh, nasa ibaba, di ba? Downtrending, nasa ibaba. That is supposed to be a bullish doji. So, totoo naman yon, may katotohanan yon. But again, if this is going to be a bullish doji, gusto natin na ang bullish doji ay ganito. Ito yung candle body, and then ito yung wick sa baba, and then ito lang yung wick sa taas. Gusto natin, kung bullish doji ito, gusto natin mas mahaba yung wick sa baba. Pero anong nangyari, mas mahaba yung wick nito sa taas kaysa sa baba. So, that is indicating or that is showing me na is still has been rejected upon trying to break this recent highs ng wicks. Okay? So, ayun lang siya. Again, if this, wala pa naman magbabago, wala pa rin breakdown na nangyayari. If we are going or if I am going to see an open and close below this support area, okay, below this support area, if I'm going to see an open and close below this support area, the most probable scenario is mag-hit si Bitcoin ng target. So, anong target? Again, this is going to be the target for this bearish expanding triangle pattern. So, kung bago ko dito, baka hindi mo alam, this is the bearish expanding triangle pattern. This is the resistance and then this is the support. Again, if we see an open and close below this support area, the most probable scenario is for it to retest this recent support area to confirm it as a new resistance and eventually continue to go down. Okay, so again, if this is going to be the breakdown point, no, if this is going to be the breakdown point, let's say the news or the Powell is going to share a negative news later, pwede siya magkaroon ng breakdown dito and this is going to target at around the 19.5K-ish area. That is based on my honest opinion. Okay, so yun lang siguro for the daily chart. No, lipat na tayo ngayon dito sa ating 4-hour chart. So recently, meron tayong shinare dito that this could be a potential bearish pennant. Hindi ko na kayo i-recap dito, panoodin niyo na lang yung recent videos. This could be a bearish pennant and then this is the pole, okay? That is going to be the pole. Bakit hindi ko siya kinonsider as a symmetrical triangle? Kasi nga meron siyang mahabang pole dito. So kapag ganyan, obvious na obvious that could be a potential pennant or a flag if ever na meron kayong makitang ganyan. So for me, this is going to be a potential bearish pennant. More probable yun sa akin. So, tingnan natin ngayon, no? So, dito, ito yung kanyang price action, di ba? So, the price action is something like this. Nagkaroon dito ng fake out. So, ba't nagkaroon ng fake out? Pansinin nyo, this blue EMA, this is the EMA 20. And it rejected the price action not once, not twice, not thrice, but 4 times. Okay? 4 beses niyang nireject ang price action. Kadalasan, sa lower time frames, kapag ganyan, is ang sunod na move is a sudden move to the downside. Possible ba magkaroon pa to ng possible move to the, extended move to the downside? Pwede. Bakit? Kasi kung papansin ninyo, nagkaroon na siya dito ng close below this support area. And if this current candle, itong current candle na to, if ganyan lang siya magko-close, no, if mag-open and close lang siya below this support, the most probable scenario is mag-wick up lang siya dito sa next candle and eventually, go down further or continue down further. So since nag-adjust yung ating breakdown point, hindi siya dito nag-breakdown, dito siya nagkaroon ng breakdown, adjust natin yung target syempre. So this is now going to target at around approximately the around the 21k-ish area. No, so again, if this support breaks down, okay, if this 4-hour support and resistance area breakdown, next possible scenario is for it to test this daily support and resistance area, di ba? Resistance, break above, and then support, and then support. So that is going to make sense if ever na itetest niya ulit ito. Before, let's say, if mag-bounce, gusto natin makakita dito ng bullish divergence. Pero as of right now, wala akong nakikita ng ganun. So, syempre, hindi pa naman lumalabas to. So, again, my most ideal scenario is for it to do something like this. Yan. So, tingnan natin if, hindi pala kita. Yan. So, yan yung idea ko. Okay? So, again, it doesn't have to happen just because sinabi ko, no? Huwag nyo ititrade yung mga pinagsasabi ko dito. Again, you have to have your own charts. You have to trust yourself. Okay? So, bago ang lahat, bago ako magpatuloy, kung hindi pa kayo nakakabisita dito sa website ko, na nandyan sa description box yung link, puntahan nyo, makikita nyo dito. If you want to show some support to me, pwede kayo mag-create ng BingX account kung wala pa kayo. And then, nandito lahat ng social media ko. Naayos ko na yung Discord server. This is the link. Papalitan ko yung invite link dyan. And then, these are the trading courses. May Bitcoin white paper and everything. Lahat yan libre. Para sa inyong trading psychology, para umayos yung mindset nyo, para maging financially literate kayo, kailangan meron kayong self-development books. Lahat yan libre. Ito, nasimulan ko na kahapon. Napakaganda basahin lahat yan. Nabasa ko na in chronological order. Kung paano ko sinerga, nung ko siya binasa isa-isa. So, I suggest basahin nyo rin sila. And then, ito, trading books for technical analysis. Again, all of these are for free. Okay? So, yun lang. Punta na tayo dito sa next chart ko. So, this is going to be the Bitcoin dominance chart. Again, the target for this breakout from this area or from this area is going to be the top of this ascending or descending channel on the weekly time frame. As of right now, if I am going to zoom in, okay, obviously, alam ko nang napakita ko na itong triangle na to sa inyo. Panoorin nyo dito or dito sa recent video natin if gusto nyo malaman kung ano meron dito. So, kung pagmamasda natin, if I'm going to zoom in, ayan, para mas kita dito sa screen. Kung papansin nyo, the Bitcoin dominance current daily candle is looking bullish. But the daily candle ni Bitcoin is looking bearish. Ibig sabihin, this movement is legitimate. Marami talagang may nagbebenta talaga BTC. Okay? So, ayun lang. Again, if this is going to continue to go up and the Bitcoin price action is going to continue to go down, the most probable scenario is if the DXY could be breaking out from this bull flag. Okay, again, the target for this bull flag is this one. But if this is going to make a sideways movement after hitting this area, that is going to make sense as well. Kasi nga, ang ating initial target talaga is from this falling wedge pattern. Na nag-breakout, nag-form ng flag, nag-breakout yung flag, and then ngayon, nag-perform ulit ng another flag. So, if this is going to hit the target, or if mag-hit dito, and then mag-sideways, and then eventually go up, that is going to make sense as well. But again, if the dollar is going to be strong, again, if this is going to continue to go up, I doubt that the crypto market is going to hold its value. Why? Kasi it is a high-risk asset. If you want to know more about that, about my opinion, panoorin mo tong video na to. Yun lang, kung umabot ka sa part ng video na to, i-comment mo dyan na Happy Tuesday. At huwag mo na rin kalimutan mag-like, comment, at subscribe. Yun lang, everyone. As always, secure your profits and protect your capital, not losses, without mercy. Yun lang, everyone. Let's go.